What's up, guys? Hope you had a great Memorial Day weekend. Now, I know most of us probably had some fun because we talked about it getting ready last week. So after a long break, what do we do? How do we get motivated? How do we stay going? This is where my 10 core concepts come into play. And what are those? We're gonna start very simple with number one, you get in a high protein breakfast. Number two, make sure you're drinking plenty of water. And number three is the one I always say, never miss it. Do your workouts, never miss your Mondays. What you want to do for number four is make your healthy lifestyle a permanent thing, and you do that through using the first three core concepts. Number five, get out there and walk more. Park further away. Don't park up close. Use the stairs. Stay away from the elevators. And what do we do when it comes to nutrition, which played really big into this past weekend as our number six rule? That is my 80-20, 80% of the time, clean, lean, tight, 20% of the time, have fun, like you did this weekend. Now, another thing that we like to think about is we have seasons of training, right? Well, that's not true. Your training season is all year long, and that is my number seven core concept, and it's based around the principle of different kinds of exercise routines during different times of the year. If you're in your actual athletic season, you shouldn't be training one way, you should be training another. And if you're postseason and in the off season, you should be training a certain way and not the other. The same thing goes for lifestyle. Summer we train one way, winter we train another. So remember, it's a year-long training thing. Now, one thing that we all tend to do a lot of, which comes into my number eight rule, and you really should not do that, is focus on weight and weight alone. Why is that? Because yes, adipose weighs something, but muscle weighs something as well. And if you're doing the proper kind of training, you're losing adipose and visceral while you're putting muscle on, and the scale may not be an accurate tool. Now, something that I like to do is I like to spend time with my family and go out to eat. But realistically, 80-20 rule, remember? Keep that to cooking at home, making clean meals as much as possible. And that is my number nine concept. Now, number 10 is something that we tend to do on and off, but I find that if I can get my clients and the people that I'm working with to maintain this on a regular basis, their success is significantly and exponentially higher. Write down, keep logs, track your progress, track your regressions, so you can see the trends causing you to go either way. Now, those 10 core concepts are what turned me from a very large, unhealthy, dare I say, dying man into 175 pounds of athletic muscle at 47 years old. Okay, guys, listen. Took me a long time to develop those concepts. Use them. You'll succeed. All right, that's what we're going with this week. I'll talk to you tomorrow.